Hello, my dear students of PSC final year or sixth sem students. I, Mr. Anand, working as assistant professor in chemistry at ADB first grade college, Arpanadu. I welcome you all for the video lecture series. Today I am going to discuss on the molecular spectroscopy of the paper 8. And which comes under the physical chemistry section. This molecular spectroscopy is a big chapter from which have the more number of questions are expected in the question paper. The study of molecular spectroscopy includes different parts. Means the first one is introduction of the molecular spectroscopy, and the second one is a study of the rotation spectroscopy. Third is a study of vibration spectroscopy, and fourth one is a rotational and vibration spectroscopy. So my dear friends, we shall go for the study of the molecular spectroscopy. Now, as I told you, molecular spectroscopy has three parts. First one is part one. Now, what is molecular spectroscopy? And what is spectroscopy? The study of the interaction of the electromagnetic radiations with the matter can be used to obtain the information about the identity and the structure of substances. Now, when you come to the spectroscopy is the most imperative and promising tool for the structural investigation of chemically relevant system. It deals with the interaction of the EMR with the matter. It can be used to extract very useful information like a structural and other physicochemical properties of molecules. Means the spectroscopy has a wide applications. Here now, the spectroscopy you can see in term chemistry, in physics and biology, and especially the spectroscopy concept already discussed in other branches of chemistry, maybe in organic chemistry and inorganic chemistry in other semesters. But we are mainly concerned with this semester, the discussion about the spectroscopy and the physical section. And again, we have the three: physics, chemistry and biology. And also here, no, from this spectroscopy, you can capture the points of the chemical structure and the molecular dynamics and molecular geometry. Okay. Now, as you know, this molecular spectroscopy is nothing but interaction of the electromagnetic radiations with the matter, or interaction of a light with the matter is also defined as a electromagnetic radiations concept to be taken for the discussion. Here now, electromagnetic radiations is a form of energy emitted and absorbed by the charged particles which exhibit wave-like behavior. As it travels through space, it propagates as a wave motion at the velocity of light 3×10⁸ meter per second. The electromagnetic radiations consisting of a self-sustaining electric and magnetic field are tight angles to each other and to the direction of propagation. It does not require a supporting media and travel through an empty space at the speed of light. And EMR, that is electromagnetic radiations, is emitted in a discrete units known as a photons that travels at the speed of light as electromagnetic waves. The electromagnetic energy is classified by increasing or decreasing order of wavelength. Now, as I told you, the electromagnetic radiations are nothing but a wave nature. It behaves like a wave. And here now, when that is electrically charged particles undergoes a to and fro motion, that means oscillation, and we can see this a electric field which is to be produced during a to and fro motion of the electric charged particle. At the same time, the magnetic field is also produced at right angles to this electric field. That means here it is moving along this the x-axis here. And these two are at right angles to each other. And these two also are at right angles to the direction of propagation of a propagation axis, the x-axis. When you have the word wave, the wave must have certain properties. The wave must have the wavelength, frequency and velocity and the wave number. So what is a wavelength? Wavelength is the distance between the two successive crest or trough, or it is a distance of two successive maxima or minima in a wave, that is called a wavelength. It is denoted by the symbol lambda, and it can be measured in terms of a meter, centimeter, nanometer, or in terms of angstrom unit also. So next one is what is a frequency? The frequency is nothing but a number of waves which are passing through the given point in 1 second is called frequency, or it is also a number of cycles per second is also called frequency. It is expressed in terms of hertz. And we have one more, the wave number. Wave number is nothing but a reciprocal of wavelength, or we can understand the wave number as how many number of waves which are present in a unit length. That means if you take 1 centimeter length, how many waves are can accommodate in the centimeter. So within that centimeter, how many waves are taken? So that's a wave number of waves present in a unit centimeter, that is taken as a wave number. And we have the relation. There is a lambda and nu. Lambda into nu is equal to velocity. That velocity is represented by c. C is nothing but a velocity of light. And the velocity of light in vacuum is found to be 2.99776 in 10 to the power of 8 meters per second. And as I discussed this, the electromagnetic waves or radiations are quantized. Means there is an emission of the electromagnetic radiations observed in a discrete unit, or it is a made up of stream of photons. And each photon has energy E is equal to h nu. H is a Planck's constant, nu V is the frequency. Our nu can replace by c upon lambda, and c into nu bar, that is a wave number, E is equal to h nu bar is also taken to be what is that is the energy of each photon. After the measuring the wavelength and frequency of the electromagnetic radiations, so those radiations are arranged in the increasing order of the frequency or a decreasing order of wavelength. This array of arrangement of the electromagnetic radiations in the decreasing order of wavelength or increasing order of frequency is called electromagnetic spectrum. This electromagnetic spectrum consists of various regions, that is from the radio waves to up to gamma rays. So the lowest energy is radio waves, and the highest energy waves are the gamma rays. So the radius have this, these are the values of the wavelength of different regions and the corresponding frequency and corresponding the energy. Look at this, radio has the lowest energy, but the gamma is the highest in terms of the kilos and megawatts. So this is how we have the list of this electromagnetic spectrum whose wavelength goes on decreasing and the frequency goes on increasing and the energy also goes on increasing. So this is all regarding the electromagnetic radiations. Altogether, we can conclude that the electromagnetic radiations are nothing but energy, that energy which interact the matter and which cause a different type of interactions. When this matter absorbs a radio wave region or radio wave radiations which causes a change in nuclear and electron spin, if the matter absorbs microwaves, it causes a changes in the molecular rotation, infrared causes a change in the molecular vibrations, and visible radiations causes the transition of the outer shell, that is why outer shell electrons here, and ultraviolet radiation causes the molecular dissociation, and X-ray it causes the transition of inner shell. Here is outer shell, this is inner shell electron. And lastly, the gamma rays is very powerful radiations causes a nuclear transition. Okay. So now, let us move on to take about the matter. After completion of the electromagnetic radiations, we shall move on to take a matter. When you take a matter, the firstly you have to consider the internal energy of a system or a matter. Then what is internal energy? It is a definite amount of energy possessed by any matter or a molecule is called internal energy. If we consider we also matter, we have the internal energy, but internal energy of some of different kinds of energies. If we consider myself, have the different energies. That internal energy includes the kinetic energy, rotational energy, vibrational energy, electronic energy, atomic energy. Like this, different type of energies are involved in the matter. Say, whenever this depends on the work we can do, so we can make use of that energy. Suppose if I start walking, that means I am using the rotation energy. If I start vibrating, so that is I am vibrating with the vibration energy. If I start rotating, that's rotating. Like this now, depends on the work you are going to perform, that energy is up. In the same way, the every molecule possesses a different type of energy, but mainly we are considered the three types of energies as the rotational energy, vibrational energy, and electronic energy. A rotational energy involves the rotation of molecule about the entire gravity, center of gravity, or a parts of the molecule. The vibration energy, it is associated with the stretching or contracting or bending of molecules. The bonds behave as a spiral made of wires. And electronic energy is always involves the electron, that involves the changes in the distribution of electrons by splitting a bonds or the promotion of electrons into higher energy levels. Look at this, that different types of energy, how it works in this case. Now, this is a diagramic representation of the vibrational, rotation, and the electronic energy. And you observe this is a rotation. See, this molecule undergo rotation from the center of gravity. So, when it rotation, here the rotation is used. And here this molecule, two atoms are joined by means of covalent bond. And these molecules undergo the stretching and contracting, or even it undergo bending. So this includes the use of the vibration energy. And there's a transition of electron transition. That means electron will transition from one energy level to another level. And we can say this is nothing but electronic energy. Even a spin, the electron spinning also observed, and the nuclear spin is observed. Like this, you have the different type of energy depends on the work to be done by the system, and we can make the different amount of energy can be observed. And again, we look at this, the quantization of that is electromagnetic radiations. The energies are quantized giving the set of energy levels. You take either atom or a molecule, all the energy is quantized, means every energy level is a fixed amount of energy. And when the electron comes from lower to higher, so that has to, suppose if this from E1 to E2, it requires 20 photons are required to move from lower to higher. Suppose if you supply only 15 photons, so it will not absorb. That means whenever the electron jump from lower to higher, it requires a fixed amount of energy, that is a 24. That is a, we require the quantize. That means it can have only 20 photons but not 15 to all, like this. This is a quantized, always a quantizer. When you move from top to bottom, as you know, there's a length, there's a distance goes on, decreases. This is the quantization of energy levels. Each energy level is a fixed amount of energy, that is a quantizer, a photon. Now let us go for the study of the energy levels in a molecule. In case of molecule, when the energy is absorbed, it may result into rotation, vibration, and electron transition depending upon the amount of energy absorbed. Just as electronic energy is quantized, there are only discrete energy levels in atom or molecules. The rotational and vibrational energies are also quantized. Just like electronic energy quantized, no? Even vibration, rotational energy levels also quantized. There are only discrete rotational and vibrational energy levels in a molecule. The rotational, vibrational, electronic energies of a molecule are collectively called molecular energy levels. That means when you spell the word molecular energy levels, it includes the rotational energy levels, vibrational energy levels, and also electronic energy levels. Let me see, that is a different type of energy levels in this. There are quantum levels for each of three kinds of energy. A change in the rotational level, vibration level, or electronic energy level will occur by absorption or emission of one or more photon of energy. And there is a difference in energy level. The difference between the successive energy levels of electronic changes is 450 kJ per mole. For vibrational changes, 5 to 40 kJ per mole. And the rotational changes about 0.02 kJ per mole. It may be noted that the electronic energy levels are relatively far apart because they lie away from each other, and for each electronic level there exists a number of closely spaced vibration level, and for each vibration level there exists a number of the rotation energy levels. If I say the molecule must have all three types of energy levels. Look at this, the schematic diagram present on the screen. Here now, the rotation can be observed or emitted if the molecule changes any one of its energy state. See, look at this. And here, this is a one thick blue line. This is a electronic energy level. And the second electronic energy level is second blue line. Thick line. See, this is the red line. That's upper arrow mark indicates one energy level to other energy level. This is the electronic energy levels. Again, each electronic energy level consists of a number of vibration energy levels. So this indicates a light green color lines indicates the vibrational energy levels. Even this the energy level one contains vibrational energy level, and this also got a vibrational energy levels. And each vibration energy level contains a number of rotational energy levels. See, this is a one, and this is a first one, and the zero in a vibrational energy, it contains a number of rotation. Again, this also got a number of rotational energy levels. Like this now, these are rotational energy present in the each vibrational level. See, when the matrix absorbs certain amount of energy, and whenever the electron transition occurs from lower energy level to higher energy level, the electrons will not directly enter into the second energy level, but that has to undergo transition. So they have to transit through the rotation energy levels, then to vibration, then to rotational, then to vibrational, then to rotational, then to vibrational, then to rotational, and then to what? Second electronic energy level. This is how there is a number of energy levels which includes composed of a complex transition. One more important clarity I'll give this now. So this electronic energy level 1 and 2, and this 0, 1, 2, 3 indicates the number of vibration levels present to each electronic energy levels. Here the second energy level is also 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Again, you look at this 0, and here this is one vibration. Each vibration energy level contains a number of, rotation 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Again, one contains 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. That each vibration energy contains number of the rotation energy level. So this is the electronic energy levels having n value, the vibration energy levels, this 1, 2, 3, they have the rotational energy levels. So this is totally, we have the three types of energy levels includes in each electronic energy levels. Okay. Now, when the energy is absorbed by a molecule is so large that can jump from one electron energy level to another, then as the energy required for the transition from one vibration energy level to another is much less, for one rotation level to another still less, hence the electronic transition between the is also accompanied by the transition between the vibration level as well as a rotation level. It is evident that each electronic level consists of a number of vibration level represented as a V is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, and further each vibration level consists of a number of rotational sublevels J is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3. V and J are called vibrational rotation quantum number. Because of large number of energy levels involved in the transition, the molecular spectra are much more complex than the atomic spectra. Just as atomic spectra help in the study of structure of atom, the study of molecular spectra gives even more information about the structure and properties of molecule, such as bond length, bond angles, bond strength, bond energy, shapes, dipole moment, etc. So this is the very important concept we have discussed about this one. Now, let us have the molecular spectroscopy includes two, emission spectroscopy and also absorption, or emission spectra or absorption spectra. And here now, so because of absorption, that means a transition from lower to higher is always absorption spectra, and emission is always from higher to lower. And as I told you, in case of a number of energy levels present in this each electric level, vibrational and rotational, and here there is a whenever it absorbs energy, a group of in the emission spectra or emission spectra or in absorption spectra, we can see the group of lines are close to each other, and that group of lines which are come together, and that lines in the form of band, and then it is called a band spectroscopy. Here now, whenever you go for the study of the molecular spectroscopy, it is nothing but a band spectroscopy, whereas in case of atomic spectra, it's a line spectroscopy. We have observed that when you go for the study of emission and absorption spectra, we have that clear distinction between atomic and molecular spectra. So band, because of the, as I told, the internal transition between the vibrational, rotational and electronic in error. So it includes a number of lines in an each line, each group, that is called a band, hence it is called a band spectra or band spectroscopy. Now let's go for the different types of molecular spectra. In case of molecular spectra, the absorbed energy is not only utilized for the transition of the electrons, but a part of energy is utilized for the rotation of the molecule and also vibration of the molecule, depending upon the amount of energy absorbed by molecule. There are three types of molecular spectra. One is a electronic spectra, and second is a rotation spectra, and third is a vibration spectra. See, in case of electronic spectra, the energy possessed by a molecule by virtue of a transition of electron from lower energy level to higher energy level called electronic spectra. And this is called ultraviolet visible spectra. It appears in the ultraviolet UV region, wavelength ranging from 200 nanometer to 800 nanometer, or 0.2 micron to 0.8 micron. And the second is a rotation spectra. If the energy absorbed by the molecule is too low, that it can cause a transition only from one rotational level to another within the same vibration level. That's very important here. There is a transition, the rotation within the same vibration level, and this result obtained is called a rotation spectra, and it's observed in case of microwave region. Therefore, it's also called a microwave spectra. And lastly, there is a vibration spectra. Lower energy photons causes a changes in the vibration energy level. The spectra obtained are referred to as a vibration spectra. These are in the region of near infrared or visible. So these are the three types of spectra which to be studied under the molecular spectroscopy.